Good evening, Senator. Good evening. Okay, we'd like to know what the discourse with the anchor being from Zambia.
Well, my younger brother is here. He came to see me, and I think I will leave him to say why.
Okay. Over to you.
I came to see my brother and a very significant leader in our land on this very day. To hear from him, his advice, his counsel, which has greatly enriched me as a person. So my assurance to him, because I have regard and respect for him a lot, people know that since 1999, I will not do anything that will bring dishonor or shame to our people. I never do it. IPOB will never be violent. We will never be armed. So there is no need for people to be afraid of the internal operations of IPOB. Because we will never, ever, ever resort to armed violence or armed conflict. That's a categorical assurance. Because our method is far more potent and sensitive. So I always listen to him, and I'll return to him from time to time to give him a little bit of his wisdom. Thank you.
Okay, we heard the IPOB is setting up a parallel security outfit. How true is that?
No, it's like you have vigilante outfits everywhere. It's not armed. We want to stop the menace of Fulani herdsmen in our land. We won't have it, we won't tolerate it. It won't happen here. In the north, you have the Hizbah police. You have the Sharia police. You even have the Janjaweed police. Here we have nothing. We need to protect this very land from people. And also, I'll hastily add, the Fulani cattlemen from Rustling as well. We are opposed to every form of disorder and criminality.
Okay, when you say you want to protect your people, are you saying that the Nigerian police force, they are not doing enough?
They have done nothing. Absolutely nothing. Fulani has been rampaging everywhere. President Buhari spoke. He never mentioned the menace of Fulani herdsmen. His interest was purely Biafra unity, threat, and intimidation. That doesn't work with me. It may work with you, but it doesn't work with me. You don't intimidate me. I am a Biafra. Nobody can. I assure you.
So how do you fund the construction? We see you are repairing some sports, portions of roads and Umaya. How do you get funding for
that? IPOB is very wealthy. We are found in over 100 countries around the world, the greatest mass movement of its kind anywhere in history. We are very formidable, I'm sure. Financially and otherwise.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so
as the chairman of the Senate Southeast Caucus, we didn't know what he discussed, but from what he said he's going to talk the line of peace. So may we hear from you, sir?
Yes, the Southeast Caucus of the National Assembly, we decided that it was also necessary for us to have discussions and interaction with the IPOB. You will recall that the Southeast Caucus were instrumental to this deal. We all discussed it. But we know that today there is a lot of misconceptions and misunderstandings, and so much tension in the land. So we want to de-escalate the tension. And to do that, you have to discuss, you have to know where everybody is coming from, and he has assured us that IPOB is non-violent, will continue to remain non-violent, and will not in any way do anything that will lead to bloodshed. But we have also told him our own stand, and our own stand is that we cannot continue this nation the way it is. There must be restructuring, there must be devolution of power, there must be a discussion by the component parts of this country to make sure that each and everyone in this country will have, to borrow the words of Obama, a better union, a far more promising union for each and every one of us. Not a union that you will have some people having a feeling that there are first class and there are others who are second class citizens. We have had a very fruitful discussion, and I'm very grateful to him for giving us the reassurance and the assurances that we have. And we want to call on Nigerians to work for the unity of this country and peace in this country. There's not any single one of us that want us to devolve into any conflict, and we don't want our land to be used as a conflict base. So we want to also continue this discussion. This is not the last discussion, it's just like a preliminary discussion. The caucus will also meet as we come back to the after our recess, and we will continue to engage all persons, all groups, all associations to ensure that everyone will be assured of equality and justice. We want to be sure that there are, nobody will be treated differently. And we want to also see Nigeria not as an oppressive state, but a state where we can fully exercise our rights as citizens of this country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.